What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel for another Steam Deck video, and this time we're coming with the preview channel's update for 3.5. So Steam Deck OS 3.5 preview is here. Now, I was mostly in stable, so a lot of cool changes in here for me to look at, and we're going to look over the patch notes really quickly here, and then we'll actually jump onto the Steam Deck and look at some of these changes. So in display, the default color rendering for Steam Deck has been adjusted to emulate the sRGB color gamut. This gives you a warmer, more vibrant color display, which is really nice to see, and you can adjust these and the color temperature as well. We'll go in and look at that later on in the video in game. As far as general goes, they fix an issue with workloads causing some CPU performance with SMT not being manually disabled. External devices now auto mount to the Steam Deck. Updated graphics driver for better performance functionality, including Starfield. So I do plan on taking a closer look at that as well. We'll talk about that more later. Better connection for Bluetooth and a bunch of other good improvements here for general, which is great to see. Dive in and look at all these notes. I'll leave a link in the description. For firmware 116, added voltage offset settings. They did fix a rare issue where a TDP limit would cause your CPU and GPU issues for the 400 and 200 megahertz. I never had that issue, but let me know if you did. And then the charging light coming on when you're already fully charged. I've always had that, but apparently they've fixed that. And then some updates here for SteamOS and the desktop mode just in general. I'll leave a link to the description in the description for you to go check that out as well if you want to. So now jumping over here onto the Steam Deck, I want to actually look closer at some of these changes. And of course, you do need to be on the preview channel right now anyway if you want to check out 3.5. So I did change this deck over to preview, updated to 3.5, and got into all the changes here. And to verify, you can always scroll down here and see your OS version. So 3.5. Now, if we go over to display, we've got some new options in here. We have the adjust display colors, which is one of the ones I like to be able to mess with. And we'll look at this in-game a little bit later here. And then down lower, we've got some HDR. So we have enable HDR here, which I could do with my capture card here if I wanted to and my pass-through. And then if we come all the way down into the advanced settings towards the bottom, we'll have some more options for enable HDR heat map. We have the SDR content brightness when HDR is on, which is really handy, and use native color temperature. So some good stuff to use in there as well. For our storage area, we've got DLC and shaders that now show up as their own separate places that they take up storage, so that you can see what's using up your space. So I always welcome more transparency as to what's taking up space on the Steam Deck. Now, if we go into our other side menu here, overlay is something we'll take a look at changes here in game shortly as well. We also have the enable VRR now over here. So for variable refresh rate, if that's supported on your dock, monitor, whatever, you'll be able to enable that. Our HDR toggle is also out here. We have our tearing right here, which they did fix the issue apparently with performance issues with overlays with tearing, so you should be able to use that. And of course, those fixes for TDP and all that. More scaling modes with the fit, stretch, fill area here, and some nice small improvements for that. Now, jumping over in game, let's take a look at the overlay at the top of the screen. So this is the new overlay in preview for 3.5. I'll show you a comparison here before that. So you can see the differences. We now have the VRAM. It doesn't say game scope anymore. They've moved the frame rate and frame time. It all just makes a little more sense, a little cleaner. So I definitely prefer the updated version of that. Now, as far as those display settings, let's jump in here and take a look at that. So we'll go over here into our settings for display. And if you go into that area we were looking at earlier for adjust display colors, that will bring up your sliders at the bottom, which is really cool in game to be able to adjust and change things because each game can really be different. So I like that. So you can slide all the way down to native and get the original Steam Deck experience there. You can go to the new sRGB, which is a little bit more vibrant and warmer, and all the way up to boosted and anywhere in between there. So a really nice detail. I used to use, to do some of this kind of stuff already. So I like seeing this built in. I'll definitely be using this, especially on the sRGB, maybe a click above. We also have color temperature here. So if you're wanting to make something cooler or warmer, you'll be able to jump in and do that as well, with 7500K being the default, which is pretty much where I leave things. But you can definitely adjust from there to your liking, which is nice to see. And being able to jump in while you're in game, I think that's really handy as well. So overall here, I think that the update 3.5 is looking really good. I'm having a lot of fun with it here on preview and messing around with some of the new stuff. Valve just keeps making the Steam Deck better, I'm sure. This will be headed over to the stable channel soon enough, which will be nice to see. But if you're on preview or want to jump over to preview, you can get in and check this out. I'll definitely be doing a Starfield video. I think I'll compare the 3.5 and the 3.4 OS and see if there's any actual difference there, since they did mention Starfield specifically in the 3.5 update. All right, guys, thanks a lot for coming and check out the video. As always, I really appreciate it. And I'll see you guys in the next one.